Mira, escoge.
So there was one year when the Rebbe said the Sichas in the days of Einam Tzadim, the Rebbe would say a lot of times, Biyurim, in Hilchas, Beis Abchina. So the Rebbe started off the Biyur saying that the Yais were in the Elef HaShishi. So the Mele is going to speak about Perek Shishi. This was the Akdama, the Perek Shishi of the Rambam. Hilchas, Beis Abchina. So the Rambam says over there in Perek Shishi, Hamikdash kulay lahe b'mishir elamay lahar. The Hamikdash was not straight, not flat. It was going up a mountain. And when a person goes in the Shaar Mizrachi of Harabayis, he goes out Safachil, the Shaver, then he goes up from the Chil to Ezras Noshim. And there's 12 steps, and the Rambam calculates how big every step was. Then he goes with Ezras Noshim, the Shaver, until Ezras Yisrael, and then there's 15 steps to go up to Ezras Yisrael. Again, the Rambam calculates how wide and how tall every step was. And then he goes through the Ezras Yisrael until Ezras Kainim, and again there was a step over there, Amor. And then he goes through Ezras Kainim, there was Beach, and he goes again up to the Ulam, and he goes to the Ulam with 12 steps, again, how the measurements every step. And then the Rambam says, Ulam Vahichol Kulei Beshav. The Ulam and the Heichal was everything was equal over there, it didn't go up anymore. So, in the words of the Rambam starts off and says that Mikdash Kuloi Loi Hoi B'Mishir Ela B'Maila Ahar. So the Rambam could have written it simple, and he could have written that Mikdash Kuloi Hoi B'Maila Ahar. The Mikdash was in the mountain. He doesn't have to write that Loi Hoi B'Mishir Ela B'Maila Ahar. So this the Rambam points out that Hayyos the Rambam says the beginning of Hilchas Beis Abchira that the whole Indian of building the Beis Hamikdash is behemshech the Vasi the Mikdash Shechanti Vaseichem of the Mishkan, and the Rambam brings a whole list of all the main the Inyanim Ikrim in the Beis Hamikdash. It has to be a Kedesh and a Kedesh Hakedoshim and a Ulam, and it has to be a Chatzar and like the Chatzar Ayel Meil. The Rambam brings all the main points of the Mishkan. And therefore, we might think that since in the Mishkan, we don't find anywhere that the Mishkan was going up in different levels. The Mishkan was all b'mishir, it was all flat. So you might think that the Beis Hamikdash also is the same thing, because that's the one of the we're copying the Mishkan. So on this, the Rambam says that to be sure of this, to exclude this, the Rambam says that the Mishkan kuloi loy hoy b'mishir ela b'maylar. What's the Maila Ahar? In a different sikha, the Rebbe explains that the Maila Ahar, there's two diyukim over here. Because the Rambam could have said, Ela Bahar. Or he could have said, Ela Bamaila. Could have said one or the other. What's the two lashanas of Bamaila Ahar? So the Lashon Har could mean that it could be that it's on top of a mountain, but it's flat. The mountain is flat, you go up a mountain, and there's a flat area, and the whole Beis Hamikdash is flat on the top. So it wasn't just Bahar, it was B'mayla Ahar. Also, on the Har itself, it could have been that it was Meshufa, the Beis Hamikdash was slanting. We find in the Mishkan, the one and only time in the Mishkan, they had to go up somewhere, but they had to go up on the Mizbeach. There was no steps, it was a ramp. So maybe the Beis Hamikdash also had in it ramps to go up, and it wasn't necessarily B'maylis. So the Rambam says, no, it has to be not only Bahar, but it has to be B'maylar. It has to be Dafka with steps going up. And it's not just enough to write Maila, because you could have steps on a regular street too, in a regular house, without being on a Har. So it has to be both things. It has to be on a Har, and also it has to be B'maylar. It has to be that each level goes up step, and there's 12 steps, or 15 steps, whatever it is, from level to level. Now, the fact that the Rambam is a Sefer Halachas, and the Rambam is not telling us a story, and not telling us that it just happened to be that it was built on a mountain, it's a chrechi, it has to be like that, and that's the Lashon of Loi Hoya B'Mishir Ela B'Maila Ahar. It's mashma that's Leikuva, that it's ma'akiv, that it has to be built dafka in such a way, and dafka on a mountain, and dafka in a way that the steps going up from level to level. So So the question is that if Taka were going back to the Mishkan and was saying that the Beis Hamikdash was a hemshach to the Mishkan, and in the Mishkan everything was flat, why Taka was it built like that? Why Taka did the Beis Hamikdash have to be built going up level to level when in the Mishkan it was not, everything was the same, the Chatzah, the Yomlei, the Kiddush Kedoshim, was all the same. So even though Taka there's many differences in the Beis Hamikdash and the Mishkan, and first of all, we need to have a reason, Taka, of everything, why it's different. Number two, the reason is really very simple in many, many parts, because the Mishkan was only, it was Arai, and the Beis HaMikdash was built with stone and so forth. And the fact that the Rambam also says that the Mishkan, the Mikdash Kula Loi Hoi B'Misha Elu B'Maila Ar, must be that it's Dafka, not like the Mishkan. It wasn't just stone. So if we look at the difference in the Mishkan and the Beis HaMikdash, the Mishkan, of course, everybody knows, was a binyan arai. It says by Mishalach Ba'el of a Mishkan, and the Beis Hamikdash was a diras keva. And once the Beis Hamikdash was built, so Nesru Kalam Mekemus, Livnis Ben Ba'is Lashem, Lachim Kegabonis, and only the Beis Hamikdash, only Aharon Miriam. What's the difference? The difference is that in the Mishkan, Taka the Chalakim of the Mishkan, the Kroshim and the Yiriyis and so forth, had a certain kedusha. But the kedusha was on the nimshach v'sham n'mishkan and so forth. But the kedusha was only on the actual items which the mishkan was built. But the makim ha-mishkan was not niskadosh. There are brings that even if we find that even in the times of the mishkan, if you needed to take afar a mishkan for the seita, it was only because the mishkan was there, but the place itself had no kedusha. And as we find that, like after Har Sinai, there's no kedusha left in the makim of Har Sinai. The same as the Mishkan, as the Mishkan traveled, so the new place of the Mishkan came to the old place now, did not retain any of the kedusha. Hashem can be some mikdash. The din is that Rambam brings a makrivim karbonis kula and alpish in a bayis bonui, and earthly kachi kedoshim of halazara, even though it's chareva and there's no machitzas around. So therefore, the kedusha stays. And even if there's no Beis HaMikdash, but the Kedusha is a makim, the Kedusha of the Beis HaMikdash is there the whole time during the void. And therefore, the Rebbe uses this Nekuda to explain why the Beis HaMikdash was built b'mayla ahar and not b'mishir. Since the place was Kaddish, the makim was Kaddish, and therefore it was pale in the makim HaMikdash, in the Shetach, in the actual area of the har, and therefore every place, every part of the har, depending on the kedusha, went up in a higher level. So we started off with there's a har abayis, and then there was the chil, there's noshim, there's yisrael, there's keinim, and so forth. Everything went up in a level because the kedusha permeated into the place, and therefore each place had a special level in the gashmius of the land because the kedusha was different. So if it was not the same, Hashem came to the Mishkan, the Kedusha didn't stay and didn't retain the place, so therefore it wasn't necessary to have different levels. And therefore the Rambam says, the Rambam is madrish this chiluk, to show that the fact that the Mishkan was takeber, not the Mishkan, was Mailahar, this Nekuda shows the chiddush of the Beis HaMikdash, that because it was a makim Ashivcha Hashem, so this was pale in the Kedushas HaMakim, and therefore the areas had to go up. The Gashmias also was higher. If you say, the Shaila says the Rebbe, that if everything went up from level to level, and we just went through all the levels of the Beis HaMikdash, from there's just Nashim, and there's just Yisrael, and there's just Kainim, and so forth, and then the Ulam and Echal, so then the simple question is, why by the Kedush HaKadoshim don't we find that it was higher up than the Kedush? Of course, the Kedushim was a lot greater. And therefore, the place of the Kedush HaKadoshim should have been based on this explanation. The place of the Kedush HaKadoshim should have been a lot higher up than everything else, because the Kedush is a lot higher. So the Rebbe says this could be explained with looking at the difference in the Mishkan and the Beis HaMikdash al pi chassidus. We find the place of the Mishkan, so it was made, Be'ikya, it was made from Tzemeach and from Chai. There was the Yiriyos, and there was the Kroshim and so forth. We'll get back to it soon. And just the Karka Mishkan was named. The reason is, and also the Rebbe says that this actually mirrored, it showed us the whole Seida Hashtalshlis. it wasn't just because it wasn't Peil Shinu in the Gashmias, but this it wasn't, forget it, it wasn't to Peil to bring about a Shinu in the Gashmias and show that and the Gashmias, the parts of the Mishkan became holy, but and the place became holy, but to show us the descent of the Seder Shalshus. And we look at the Mishkan from the Milmaila Lamata, the top covering of the Mishkan was made from the Eres Elim Adamim, the Eres Tchashim, it was from Chai. Then it went down the next level, and also the Eres Izim was from Chai. Then we go down to the next level, that the Kashia Mishkan. And the Kashia Mishkan was from Tzemeach. And even in the Yiriyah, in the bottom Yiriyah, there was also a miut of the Yiriyah was also made out of Tzemeach, the Sheish. And then there was the Kroshe made out of Tzemeach. And then came the Karka, then came the Adonim were made out of Kesef, and so forth. And then offer the earth of the Mishkan, which was David. So this was the Seder by the Mishkan. When it comes to the Beis HaMikdash, the Beis HaMikdash, the whole Kavod of the Beis HaMikdash was to be prayed that Dira B'Tachteinim, and it should penetrate and permeate into the Gashmis of the world. And therefore, this had to be, the Mishkan, the Beis HaMikdash had to be built on a har, because it had to be higher than everywhere else, because it was pale on everywhere else and so forth. And therefore, based on that, every place in the Beis HaMikdash was on a higher level, because the Kedusha was higher and so forth, and this was to be pale in the Gashmis of the world. So every place, the Gashmis had to be higher up, the Mishkan, the Beis HaMikdash B'chlal was higher than all places around, and then the Ezra's Noshim, Ezra's Yisrael, and so forth, because it was pale in a higher level in the Gashmis. Hashenki in the Mishkan, it wasn't pale in the Gashmis B'chlal, and because it wasn't pale, so everything could be the same and equal, it made no difference of the level could all be one level. With this, we'll understand why the Kiddush HaKadoshim was not higher up than the Beis HaMikdash. When can we say that we go up in a higher level from level to level? That is only when the next level is Be'erech. It is in comparison to the lower level. So we can say that if you want to go up from the Ezra's Noshim to Ezra's Yisrael, you have to go up 12 steps. And the Rambam calculates how high the step was and so forth. You're going up a level. You have to go up 15 steps. You have to go up this number of steps and so forth. When it comes to the Kiddush HaKadoshim, even 1,000 steps won't help. Because the Kedusha of the Kiddush HaKadoshim is so great that you can't have a certain amount of steps and say the Be'erech, the previous level of where the Mizbeach was, then you have to go, then you, so you go to the, sorry, you go up to the Ulam and to the Kiddush, then you're gonna go up a certain amount of steps, a certain level to go to the Kiddush HaKadoshim. Not Shayat Bukhal. Because the Kedusha of the Kiddush HaKadoshim is so great that it's Inyan of Nimna and Amnois, the Makim Ma'arin, Einim and Amida. There's no, that this cannot come out in a practical way and say that a certain amount of steps will make the difference between the Kesh and the Kesh Gadashim. And therefore, it had to stay the same, because in the Gashmias, it was not shy to bring this up. The Rebbe finishes off and says, if you look in the Lashon of the Rambam, a very interesting Inyan, we look in the Lashon of the Rambam over here. The Lashon of the Rambam says like this. Kesha'odam nichnes mishar mizrachi el shal har habayis, mahalech ad seif achil b'shove, ve'eila min achil ezras noshim, 12 miles. He has to go through the entire level, and then go up from the chil to ezras noshim 12 steps. Then he has to go mahalech kol ezras noshim b'shove, ve'eila. And then he goes into the next level. And the Rambam is telling us each the person's level, that if you go through this entire level, you mahalach through this entire level, then you can go up to the next level. You go through this entire level, you can go to the next level. And therefore the Rambam is telling us this is the aliyahs, that this will be pale on the person on aliyah. That if he goes up to this level, he'll go up to a higher level. So he goes up to the next level, he goes up to the next level, he goes to the next level, and so forth. When it comes to the Kiddush HaKadoshim, the Rambam doesn't say that it's mahalach kol ulam and kol kedush, and then he's over to the Kiddush HaKadoshim, because in the Kiddush HaKadoshim he's already bottled by Metzias, and once he's bottled by Metzias, it's kulei b'shove. He's not anymore a Metzias, that he reached a certain height, a certain level, a certain thing, and therefore it's kulei b'shove to the previous level. He doesn't have to say that he's over to the level of Kiddush HaKadoshim because he's on the same level as before. And this is in the Beis HaMikdash. The Kiddush HaKadoshim of every single Yid that over here, that the pnimius, the yechidah of every single year, there's no tzir and akbala anymore. It's a ganz mavatel leibish and so forth. And the Rebbe finishes off and says that this is the dogma of the Kohen Gadol, who's the shliach of every year. It goes into the Kodesh Kodashim Achaz Bashana. It's interesting that in the not Mugadig Sicha, this is a Sicha in Chilich of Tess, the not Mugadig Sicha, the Rebbe finishes off this whole beer and says, "Betel Lachachem Yachkevit."